When Morris extended to me the honor of saying Hamotzi and offering a word, he did so on the condition that I not speak about him and Nancy, but rather that I speak about why Hillel is so important. And so, breaking a bit with protocol, but in deference to my congregant, I'd like to say why Hillel is so important to me in the most personal of terms. I think back to my junior year of college, and though I came from a traditional home, once at University of Michigan, with the freedoms of campus life, I wasn't very involved at all in Jewish identity. One Friday afternoon in my junior year of college, my mother called me to tell me that Mr. Genden, the grandfatherly figure who sat next to us in shul, slipping us a peppermint candies as the rabbi was about to speak, had passed away that week. Not really knowing what to do, but knowing that I had to do something, I decided to go to Friday night services at Hillel to say Kaddish. I told my friends that I would be a bit late for our usual Friday night outing, and I called one of my Jewishy friends to find out the particulars of the Friday night service and where to go. I knew no one in my 2 years up till then of campus life. I had only been to high holiday services. I sat through the Friday night service. I said Kaddish for Mr. Genden, and like at the end of a long flight, I popped up out of my seat ready to leave the building. I was home free, and then a man popped up and boxed me out and looked at me and said, "Excuse me, I noticed you've never been here before." At which point I recall thinking, wow, this guy has an astute sense of the obvious. I only found out about this building about an hour ago. At which point he said, "Well, I was wondering if you have plans for Shabbos dinner." And truth be told, I lied, figuring he didn't really want to hear about dollar pitcher night at Rick's that night. And then he said something that I'll never forget. He said, "Well, I bet you don't have plans for next Friday night." At which point, I sheepishly shrugged, and he said, "Good, so I'll see you then." So the following week I went, and I became a Hillel board member, led the pro-Israel group to D.C., edited the Jewish Student Journal, went to rabbinical school, got a doctorate in modern Jewish studies, became rabbi of Park Avenue Synagogue, and just a moment, we'll say Hamotzi. The man that evening was Michael Brooks, the Hillel director at University of Michigan, and he continues to be my model of Jewish leadership up till today. When you come to a dinner like this one, when you support Hillel International, it's understandable to mistake it for a faceless organization, yet another dinner in a New York spring filled with dinners and hamotzis. But I know, and I know here I do speak for our honoree Morris as well, that the power of Hillel, the power of this evening, comes down to the ability to touch a single human soul. Yes, we are supporting an institution with a global reach, but what we're really doing is enabling Hillel to do what it did for me, what it's done for thousands of others, and what it will, God willing, with your support, do for thousands more, to identify, to touch, and to shape Jewish souls at the crossroads of their campus lives. It's every bit as momentous, every bit as sacred as that. To Morris, to each of you, thank you, and may Hillel move forward in strength.